Hi, everybody. We're going to take a look at some rhythms today, but we're going to use our recorders. So let's take a look first at this rhythm pattern. This happens through most of these slides. We have this pattern right here with the eighth note, quarter note, eighth note. Let's think about what that would sound like when we count that out. This lands on the beat, on beat one. So we would say ta. This is on the second half of beat one. So imagine you had two eighth notes together. What would be the second half? D. So this, we say D, but we have to hold it a little bit longer, right? We're holding it for a whole beat. And then this is on the second half of beat two. So we would say D. So let's clap this rhythm pattern out together, the whole thing. One, two, ready, go. Ta di di ta ta. All right, we're ready to take a look at what we're going to be doing on the recorder, and that is E, low E, and low D. So I'm going to start by making a G first with my thumb, pointer, middle, ring. And then for E, I'm going to use my right hand. I'm going to put my thumb back here, my pointer, and my middle, and that is low E. When I do low D, I'm going to add the next finger down, which is my ring finger. And we're going to be doing all low E and low D today. All right, so let's take a look at this. Let's play this on E first. One, two, ready, go. And let's go to our next one. And that one is very similar, right? We still have that same ta, di, di pattern, but it's not followed by two quarter notes, it's followed by a half note. So let's think about what that's gonna sound like. Now we just did E, so we're gonna change this one to D. One, two, ready, go. If you're struggling to get those notes sounding right, remember the two things that usually cause our sound not to be right would be the wrong amount of air, usually too much air, or our holes aren't covered. So make sure your holes are completely covered. And when we're on D and E, D and E, we need to cover so many holes. So it's hard to make sure that every single one of them is covered. It does help if you use this flat part of your finger instead of the pointer part of your finger, okay, to help get those all the way covered. Another trick and tip you can use to get a good sound on your recorder is when you go down, you change your embouchure. Watch what happens when I play. Did you see how my face changed a little bit? It was more like this on the lower notes, and that'll help you get a better sound. All right, we're gonna go on to the next one, and we're going back to D. One, two, ready, go. Now on E, ready, go. Ooh, that one's tricky. This is kind of different. I still see that same pattern, right? I see ta, di, di right there, but it's not at the beginning. We start with our ta there at the beginning. Clap this rhythm pattern out with me because it's kind of hard. One, two, ready, go. Ta, ta, di, di, ta. Great. Now let's play it on low D. One, two, ready, go. Now on low E, here we go. All right, I think that was our last one. Let me check. Yep, that was our last one. Great job, everybody. We'll see you next time.